this trick is all about fairness, and I'm going to be as fair as I can throughout. We have this deck, and Luke, I'd like you to give them a shuffle for me.
Yep.
While you're doing that, I want to bring everybody else's attention to these two envelopes. They are, in fact, my predictions. Rob, you can hold on to them. There is something inside each one. Are you happy you've shuffled and now cut, is what I see?
Yep.
Perfect. Look, I will spread these cards on the table, and I want everybody to take a moment to look through these cards and look for anything that you may consider suspicious or untoward. In fact, I'm so confident that you won't, I'm willing to offer you £20 if you do find anything, perhaps two cards in the same deck, or anything that shouldn't be there. And please take this seriously and spend a few seconds. Now, there is a reason I'm offering you this money. It's because I know for a fact this is a completely regular deck with no duplicate cards or anything suspicious. So I'm happy and confident with my offer. Anybody find anything they want to bring to our attention? Perfect. The cards will go in the box in the order that you shuffled them, Luke, and you can hold on to them for now. Because now we come to my predictions. There are two envelopes, a prediction in each. This prediction is a playing card. It's the Seven of Hearts. And this prediction is a number, 19. You can see both empty otherwise. 19, Seven of Hearts. You shuffled the deck, we put them in the card box so that I could not manipulate them in any way. Let's do this, we'll be as fair as we can, as with the rest of the trick. 19 and the Seven of Hearts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. The 19th card. So far I've not seen a Seven of Hearts, and I'll even show you these cards here. There's a Seven of Diamonds, but no Seven of Hearts. And the deck that you shuffled, you cut, everybody else checked, the 19th card is the Seven. In my mind, yours, Dennis, is shuffled is one of the most perfect card tricks to be invented in the last few years. Think about the effect and the conditions. You take two predictions that are fairly left on the table, somebody shuffles a deck of cards, and you take it in that very order and put it in the card box so that you can't manipulate it. Then you reveal the two predictions, a number and a card. When they count down to that number, their card is there. You manage to predict the card at the number. And the reason I was really taken by this trick is that it's essentially self-working, because it's not about sleight of hand, it's about a clever combination of methods. There are three or four different threads being intertwined and connecting this trick so that the outcome is the same every single time.